Hi everyone, this is Cape at Cape's Corner Creations, back again with our journal that we're working on. I thought today we'd work on some pages, not sure, don't have a plan, but that's how it goes. Sometimes you just dive in and sometimes you organize ahead of time. I do have some scraps and things available around the desk, so I thought I'd start there. So I hope everybody's well. It's a beautiful sunny day today. Puts me in a way better mood. The sun is always a happy thing. So let's dive in. I have this front cover that we had worked on this project recently, and that video will be up. And then I have a couple of pages that I've worked on. Not a lot, just a few things. I'm trying to keep this journal particularly empty so that there's a lot of journal space. But, you know, one can't help themselves when it comes to decorating. So, like this page here is not really complete, but it will be. And I will be adding to this one as well. But let's see if we can find a page or two that we can work with today. I have an idea of something, but I haven't really done it. This might be a good spot. All right, let's start here. I think that we can work on this side of the paper. I thought we'd work with some scraps, some envelopes, a tuck, making a tuck or a pocket, and not sure we'll get to a journaling card, but we can make the place for them. Okay, so I'd like to begin with covering the page with some old book pages. Well, let's see what we have here. I have a few old books, some dictionaries, some encyclopedias, and sometimes those are the great words. Let's see what we have here. Find me a page. Sometimes you have to check the words, you know, you don't want the wrong kind of words on your work. Here, this looks good. I'm just going to cut this page out. Get my handy dandy blade. There we go. Let's see now. Need glasses for this. Sometimes the words are small. Let's see. I think we're good. Okay. So we're going to start with this old page, and it's very brittle, so it will tear easily. So I'm just going to use it as a base because I'm not crazy about the bright white. Well, this paper right here is actually avocado dyed, but it's just a touch of like a pinkish brown around the edge, but for the most part, the page is pretty white. So I'm going to cover this paper. We have roast, we have boat, body, we have pretty good words. Okay. So, I'm going to go in like this and you can cover this paper with anything that's, you know, works for you, or leave it plain, or maybe just coffee dyed paper, which would be a little browner, or some stencils, whatever you think would work. I like the printed word with the old brown edges sometimes for a base. There we go. Now I'm just going to bring that up to here. And that should tear right off. And because it's so aged and caramel color, I'm not even going to ink this. I'm just going to glue it to the paper. I'm going to just trim it just a little bit. There we go. Don't even really need the whole thing, but we'll go that way. Okay. And like this on there. Now, the best way to ink a very brittle paper, I use a, which way are we going here? I'm going to use my glue stick, but we need a piece of paper so we don't glue it to the desk. It will tear. It's very fragile. So, I usually glue that. I'm thinking to glue right on the page itself and then lay it down. Well, decisions. I don't know. I think I'm going to go back to my original plan. This paper is so fragile, but if we ruin it, we can just get another piece of paper. Okay. It's going to go this way. So. All right. Let's go. Always start from the middle and work upwards, and then you can work from the middle and go down, or just turn your paper around, which is what I'm going to do, and then go the other way up. This paper is so fragile that if I mess with it, it's going to tear. So it's very old, and so we don't want to ruin a good piece of paper. So there we go. Get that sticky one out of the way. Bring this over here and then center as best you can, and there we have it. All right, beautiful. There, that looks like it belonged in there. All right, I love it. Now we're going to make a pocket. I'm thinking with an envelope maybe, or just some cardstock. See what we have here. I have some cardstock ready, but I also have this envelope. So my thought is to glue this onto here, cover this with a nice paper, and cover this with some paper. All right, let's see what we have here. If I have some in my scrap bucket. You know, we always have a scrap bucket. Let's have a... I'm just going to move this journal out the way we're working. Let's see. I think I like this... I think I'm liking this paper here. This is a masculine journal, so I don't want any lace or flowers or anything like that. But if you're making a flowery, lacy journal, then you go right ahead and pick your materials that are going to work for you. Let's measure this. This is, whoops. It'd be helpful if we started the right direction, right? Okay. Do 4 1/4 by 5 1/2 here. All right, so I'll get that cut here. Let's see if I can do this now. My goodness, it's warm today. We had a couple of weeks of cool weather, and now it's back to summer. First cut, and now let's go right here. We may need to trim that, but let's try it. Alright. See if I cut it too short. So it's a good thing we have more paper, or it's the other piece. Yeah, of course. That is easy enough. We'll just trim that. Alright, so we're going to do the same again. Get my paper and just glue stick this paper on, then I will trim the top of it. Oops. Need some more on this envelope because we don't want that white either. There we go. Cut that down. That's good. And then we're just going to trim that. There we go. Journal. So the object here is to have this here so it opens up and we have a tuck. But I'm also going to cover this side with maybe something different and the inside. So let's see. We could use more of the same here. Not sure. I don't know that that would hold up. I think we're going to use the same paper that we had for the inside. I'll turn that around. Nope, I don't want to do that. Let's see what we have. Of course, I'm dropping everything. Like a little color here. Okay, we'll go to that. So I hope you're all well. It's, like I say, it's back to summer here. Oh my goodness. And I'm loving it. So measure that again. The only problem with working off the cuff is, as you know, I don't have things pre-cut. 4 1/4 and 5 1/2. Okay. So let's try this. This color better on this side. There we go. All right. And then this piece is going to go here. And I'm going to cut a little bit off of here so we can use the pocket. So I'm not going to use the glue stick this time. I'm going to use some glue because I'm going to glue the envelope and then we can trim afterwards. So let's put some glue fun to work in the journal as you go. I don't always have a plan. I'm not one to normally plan it all out ahead of time. I usually work page by page and create as I go. I'm not the most organized crafter in the world, but I usually have good end results, so I'm sure I would make folks who are very organized a little crazy, but I do clean off my desk, several times a week, but even then some, it goes right back to crazy. All right, I'm going to bring this quite far down so we get a nice punch in our, a nice opening on our card envelope so we can get whatever we're going to put in there with ease. There we go. There, I like that. See now, that's going to go here. Well, actually, it's going to go like this, right to the edge. And over. And we'll probably put a little pocket on the front of this as well. So I'm going to put that there. But I'm not going to glue this piece to the page. What we're going to do is cut another piece. Let me see here. I'm going to use this cardstock. And I'm going to cut a piece and glue this to the page. We'll glue this envelope to the cardstock. If I can keep in camera for you. Goodness. So that when we open this, our object will be that you have your, I'm going to trim the corner on this as well, right where your envelope naturally curves. I'm going to cut that down. And it's all right that it's a little shy because we will be inking that a little bit. Let me cut that straight. And the other side. There we go. Much better. And you can ink or put another piece of paper inside here if you don't like the white. We may. Let's see about how much time we have here. Alright, so we're going to glue this to here. Put the cardstock on the page so that we have a nice held, and then we're going to use the back of the cardstock for a pocket. We'll use the inside here for a tuck. We're going to put another piece on here and put a tuck. We have your inside your envelope, and then we have the front, which we can also put another little tuck or a pocket there. So let's measure our page and cut this. So we need 5 3/4 by 5. Okay. I'm just going to do that over here. I'm not gone. Just be right back. 5 3/4. See how that is. I'll do this backwards. Nope, this way. Nope, it's this way. I think that's a little, it's big, but you know what? I think that's perfect. There we go. Alright, so first things is we're going to glue this piece right onto here. So I'm going to move this out the way. Get this right. So we will not to the crease because you want it to bend. So we're just going to go right above the crease and put loads of glue on there. There we are. If this is your first journal build, then I, first of all, congratulate you on jumping into a new craft. And remember, as a beginner, you have an abundance of things in your home. Don't be running out and buying all kinds of things. And I have a supply of crafts because of my years of being involved in craft making. You know, between sewing and crocheting and, you know, quilting and working with kids, I have a cupboard full of things. So that is my goal, is to use up these things. So I have bought a few things, but not an abundance. So holding on to old things comes in handy. There we go. Now, we are going to ink this while it's not in the book. I'll find my little ink here. And I use Distressed Oxide Vintage Photo. And these little brushes I got at the dollar store. They're great. So far, so good with that. So see, we're just going to ink around the edge here. This journal is a lot about brown. The colors, you know, tan, brown, a little orange, a little rust color. Yeah. And we're going to do the inside as well. There we go. And then over here, I'm going to forget all sides. I'm going to do this side too because we're not sure yet what's going to show and what isn't. So let's just go ahead and ink that up. We may have to trim that. I'm going to check the page for the width there. Okay, let's get that out of the way. Oop, here's another side. See? Oop, and I'm not even in camera. I need to remember to look to see what you all can see. All right, let's put this book up here so you can see. Now, I'm going to glue that down. Perfect. I do think we need a piece of paper in there. What do you think? Let's ink this crease because that looks too white. And some sort of paper right in there. I think a solid. Let me think if I have one. Let me check. Somewhere. Let me see. Here we go. I like this. I can find the one I'm looking for. Oh my goodness. Let me just grab that. I'll be right back. Okay. Now, to move things out of the way, get to it. All right. I'm really liking that already. Now, let me see if this color will work here. Not really sure. I like the way it looks leathery. I think I'm going to put something light, actually. Let's see. Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness. That's some music paper on the inside of that. No, I don't like that either. See, the thing with working, just working, you have to try different things to get something that works for you. Yeah. This is what I was looking for. Just some print light. Okay, very good. So we're going to do this. Oops. I always do that. I always turn the thing upside down. We're going to do 5.5 It's going to be a little smaller by 4 because it doesn't have to go all the way at the bottom. I've learned when I insert papers and glue them, if you go all the way to the bottom, then the glue on the back of the paper gets stuck at the bottom and sometimes closes your envelope a little bit. So I'll only bring the glue, you know, 3/4 of the way. The paper doesn't have to even reach the bottom because you can't see inside there anyway. It's just for here and that it sticks down well. So let me do that again. And we will insert that paper. 5.5. Just big enough. There we are. Yeah, let's see how that works. Oh, that's good. See? And that just looks like a written letter inside there. I'm going to show you that paper. The light is really bright here. I don't know if you'll see that very well. But I am going to ink the top of that before we glue it. Let me get this out of the way. Just the corners, just a little bit. There we go. Now, let me get my paper. Here's my green paper. And this one I am going to put the glue stick on, and we're going to do halfway. Oops, see how that caught? Glue stick and me don't work well together. I don't know if you all work well with a glue stick, but it's not my favorite. Not my favorite. And because that caught, I'm going to take a baby wipe and just wipe a little bit. Of course, it's sticking to the paper. There we go. Now, we're going to bring the... Now, the bottom I did not glue. Let me show you. This all here is not glued. But it will lay flat once you get the top secured. And we're going to just bring it right to the... Almost to the top. There we go. Just slide that up and get that gluey paper all the way. And with glue stick, though, it doesn't dry as fast as other things. You can maneuver it a little bit. Here we are. And I'm going to, again, put a little inking there. Darken that up. We want to look a little aged. And there we are. Now, it's this way. And there we have our pocket. I think I'm going to put a little stenciling around this card before we glue, so we will use some of this glue paper, fold it, move our journal so we don't get it all inked up, and then put a little stenciling on there. Or you can, you know, put another piece of paper, you can hand draw things, you can, you know, embellish the way it makes you feel good about it. Like a little stone look, or a little on an angle maybe, and some rock looking things. I like just a little bit of something to embellish the card, even though there's plenty of room to write and we are going to put a little pocket there. It still looks better than just plain. Gives you some thought of the imagination. A little beehive. Sometimes that looks good. Little stone. Let's see what else I have here. Little squares. Go this way. And go back around with some of the others. I just like a border on things sometimes. It just gives it a little character. And here we go. There we are. Get all these out of the way. There. And, you know, it's just your whatever, you know, your decorations are along the way. Like I said, this one is a more masculine journal. And if you're making a little, you know, frilly little thing, you can put on there whatever you, you know, enjoy. All right, now this is ready to glue to our page. So we have plenty of room for this to open. I like it when it opens out because you can always, you know, write on that and use it for a space to write on. And this is available for a, we're going to put a tuck, but you could always write some words there if you're, you know, inclined to use it for journaling here. And we will put something up here as well, maybe. All right, so let's glue this down to start. And we will glue. Well, we have to remember, if you want to use this as a pocket in behind, then we're only going to glue three sides. So, let's start on this corner. And, you know, about a quarter of an inch all the way around to hold it. You can use whatever glue you choose. I have used this craft glue, and I would never use the glue stick on a small space because I am not the best one with that tool. All right, there we are. Now, let's place it. And not too close to the middle of the book because you want, again, you want this space so things turn well, so you don't want to put it there. Just a little bit over is good. There. Well, that's looking really nice. I like the color choice. I think we nailed that. Sometimes you have to go slow before you glue it in the book so that if you don't like it, you can say, okay, I'm not having that. And then you can change it to something else. It's just paper. So before you get carried away, think, oh, I just ruined that paper. You can always use it for something else. You'd be surprised. Your scraps make beautiful journaling cards. I'm going to show you a piece here I have from some scraps. Let's see. Okay, so here's some that I had some. Let me put the camera up so you can see it. I have used the cream-colored cardstock. And I just glued scrap papers on here. And I will eventually cut them and use them in the journals. This one right here might be even used on this side in this particular journal. But we'll see. But so don't worry about your scraps. And don't worry about, you know, if they didn't come out just right, you can save them for making your own paper for your journal cards or tags. All right, so here we have this. Now, I'd like to put something here, so let's look in my, or we could even stencil that, but I think we're going to start with a pocket. That's what we'll do. So we're going to take some cardstock that we were just piling up. Let's see here. I know I had a piece somewhere. Let's see. Oh my goodness. I have to go in my bucket of junk and see. Alright, I'm going to cut a piece because I don't have any small things here at the moment. So we want to do a spot here, and I'm thinking straight across on the front. So so it doesn't get hung up on anything. I want to make it a little bit smaller, and I don't want it too tall, so let's cut this. So that is about 2 inches. Let's see how that works. All right, and we're going to just trim that down just a little bit. Yeah, sometimes I tackle the scissor, but not often. A little bit more. I don't want it too small, but I don't want it too big either. Let me take one more smidge off there. Cutter. All right then, and we're going to put a little bit of paper on here, or we could stencil it. So, or you could paint, or you could use colored pencils or markers or whatever your desire for art is today. We could use some of that inside paper. That would fit right here. Looks pretty nice. Alright, so this is easy. So all you gotta do with this is glue the card. Get the glue going here. We're gonna glue the card. Put the cover back on the glue. Oh my goodness. And we're gonna just set it in the corner. Down. There we are. Now, that's easier to trim like that. Okay. We could put a fancy edge on that, but I think I'm going to leave it flat and straight. I like the straight lines for this particular journal. And again, you're only going to glue three sides. Sometimes I round corners, but I really like the straight lines in this journal. I mean, there is some with the rounded corners, but I do like the straight lines. There we go. And let me grab a journal card that's made. Let's see if I have one that's gonna fit in there, just to show you. Okay, here's one. And that fits right in there like that. Now, like I said, we probably won't get to making these cards today, but we're making the pocket. And that's one. One pocket. And then you have a second pocket here, which I probably would put in a piece of writing paper, fold it up and stick it in there. You know, like some coffee dyed paper, some lined paper, and then there's a whole sheet of paper to use. So now we're going to put a tuck here as well. So we have this pocket, which would house a card, like so. We have this one. Here, I'll show you. Let me get a piece of paper. Not purple. That would not work. This is a coffee-dyed and avocado-dyed paper with the avocado first and then sprayed it with some coffee in it. Gives you those little marks. We're going to turn this up and just fold it. It's a full sheet of paper. Put a lot of writing on there. And then fold it down. And then that just slips in your pocket. See that? And now you have a journaling card here and some writing paper here. And we're going to do one more pocket here. And for here, I'd like to do a side tuck, or maybe a band. Maybe a band would be better, and it could just slip right in. What do you all think? Let me see. Where's my cardstock here? You know, we can do just a band or just a thing. I think I want to do the, side tuck. Here and to the top. So the best way to do that, I have found, is I'm going to take from this corner to the top and get my book out of the way. We're going to go from the corner to this mark here, which is the bottom of the book. Set it here. Let's see. Yeah, that's good. And at the same time, you can either cut with I use a craft knife, or your cutter, or a scissor. Whichever one works better for you. Me, that's another story. Back, and we're going to set that right there. Now I think before I glue this, I'm going to ink around the edges and then stencil the same similar things that are here onto here. So again, move the journal. You don't want to get that journal all dirty, and that would be me. Where's my brush? Oh, here we go. Alright, so we're just going to ink all the edges. You know, it just gives it a little life. As you don't want plain paper. It's pretty boring. And most of the junk journals are... Oh, that's the wrong side. You know, see, that's things I do. Not paying attention. Junk journals are basically using old things and junk that you have in the house. That's the basic for it. Some crafters embellish with store-bought and beautiful things, and that's great too. For me, I'd like a little bit of both. I like to use up my old things and my supplies, and I don't know if that's going to work, but we'll see. And, you know, give it some life with some old things. See, that's going this way, like it or not. Okay. And some stenciling. I'll get those stencils back out here. You know, it's all in good, this one for the corner. That's nice. It's so nice to see everybody's creations and inspire others to broaden your skills, because we're all stuck at home right now, and it's a good idea to encourage each other, especially for some of us who are disabled and can't really get to things or go places. It's a little more difficult with the situation that we're in right now. I'm going to grab a baby wipe because I inked my fingers as well as the cards, and I don't want to put it on my journal, so let me wipe my hands. There we go. Alright, so now we can glue this piece right here. Just like before, we're going to do just here on the two sides that we have this bucket. Maybe a little bit of a lip here so that we can use that pocket. Just a little bit of a widening, because that would help when you're putting things in and out of there. There. A little bit more ink. And some glue. Now, I'm going to do these two sides. And again, about a quarter of an inch on your card, just to make sure that it's grabbed well. Because, you know, depending on the glue, some take long to dry and others dry really fast. So, your choice in glue, but there. Now, the same with this pocket or tuck. You can stick several cards, actually, in a pocket like this. These journal cards are not going in this journal, but I'm just using them to show you. And you can put several, two or three of them in there. I will make some to go with this journal. And so I might even put something right here. I have a few more minutes. Let me see. And then I'll make journal cards later on. I'd like a little bird or something here. Let's see. Or maybe not. What do we have? Let's see. Kind of like that. I'm going to cut that circle out and see what it looks like. You know, it's always one of those things where you test your skills, and then sometimes I can't stop. You know, I get decorating, and it's like, oh, one more thing. But I am really trying to keep this journal slim. I have some that are so big and so stuffed. And this particular one, I'm really working hard to keep it on the thinner side, more of a journaling book and not so much with so much ephemera in it. I kind of like that right there. We'll do that. Can put a little ink on that. Maybe melt some more. We'll glue that down. And that's an easy one. And just glue around and around. You probably can hear lawnmowers outside. It seems everybody in the neighborhood cuts the grass on Sunday. Their day off, you know. There we have it. Okay, so now let me grab a card that maybe looked better in here. Here's one. Note to self. That could go there. I don't want to put girly ones. I'm trying to find one. Not so. Oh, here's a great one. Oh, this is great. So we'll put this one in here. There we are. And actually add this one to the front. So there's our page. We have multi-pocketed tuck slot. Oh, and we have the back. That's what I forgot. There we are. We'll put that one back there. This one here for now. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4 tucks, and you have this great big piece of paper for journaling writing. You can also use the spaces here, here, and here for journaling, and here. And how great is that? And a little bit thick, but our journal is not going to be too big. So far, it's looking really, really, really nice. I'm pleased with the decorations, and the time it takes is really not that hard with ideas ahead of time. It will go much faster. So I hope you enjoyed this today. There we are. And your envelope pocket. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4. Four tuck pocket spots. So there it is. I hope you enjoyed that today. And if you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. I really appreciate y'all joining me. We're in isolation, a lot of us. It is nice to have a community of friends who enjoy this. So you can subscribe to my channel to get upcoming videos. Like and, you know, ring that bell so that you get all the new stuff. And, oh, and you can check out my Etsy shop. There will be some price reductions, and we're going to be having new journals coming probably in a couple of weeks. So, enjoy. Thank you for joining me. Bye-bye.